Commanders, Zimbabwe National Army Charity Shield, the quarterfinals are roared into life with another explosive tie at Bulawayo's Papa Fields Stadium between Highlanders and the Chicken Inn on Sunday the 6th of March. Chicken Inn rested a fair number of their regular starting lineup, most notable Edmo Chirambadare, Captain Danny Deco Piri, Tafazo Coutinho, Lawrence Mhlanga, and Pasmo Bernard. Coach Joey Antipas was also reported absent from the match as he is attending to urgent personal matters. Highlanders have for their part fielded what should be the core of their 2016 squad. Chicken Inn, enjoying a bigger part of the possession, however, failed to translate their dominance into serious scoring opportunities. Instead, it was Bosso, starved of the ball for the better part of the first half, who had the more dangerous chances, with Chicken Inn's man of the match, goalkeeper Pride Zendera, the stumbling block. On 13 minutes, Clemens Matau, who has recovered from a hamstring injury, would get things going for Chicken Inn with an ascending shot from the edge of the box. A few minutes later, Moses Demeras Crosser would take a suicidal intervention from Eric Mzingwa to prevent from danger. Chicken Inn literally camped in the Highlanders' half, if not box, but what good is dominance if it counts to nothing? On 21 minutes, Gabriel Nyoni thought he had won himself a penalty after being tackled on the edge of the box, but the referee ruled that contact had been made outside the penalty area. Eric Mzingwa ballooned the free kick. With Bosso now settled, Bruce Kangwa would miss Zendera's right post by a few inches. Lack of concentration then condemned the Highlanders into arrears when Luke Homer, King Nadolo and Tendai Ngulube lost possession in dangerous territory. Kenan Komo then crossed over to Obadiah Tarungwa, but Felix Chidungwe and Eric Mzingwa, indecisive in defense, should take blame for their failure to clear, allowing Tarungwa to recover and finish with a rising shot. 1-0 in Chicken Inn's favor at halftime, but on resumption at the second half was a different ball game from the first, with Highlanders all over their opponents from the onset. On the 46th minute, Nox Mtizwa, on his first match for Bosso this season, perhaps still needs to shake off a little rust from the off-season as he nodded Bruce Kangwa's cross to the grandstands. Highlanders were now in control of the proceedings. It appeared a matter of time before they found what they were looking for, and Simon Munawa would see his left-footed shot from the edge of the box saved by Zendera. As chances galore fell Bosso's way, next to miss would be King Nadolo before Nox Mtizwa saw his angled shot punched away by the impressive Zendera. On an afternoon when he appeared unbeatable, the Chicken Inn goalkeeper's acrobatics would again steal the show after going airborne for a double puncher to deny Mtizwa's header. By the way, Zibora spent most of his time on the bench deputizing a 2015 Goalkeeper of the Year, Elvis Chipezeze. Such is the depth at Chicken Inn with goalkeepers. With Bosso now a torment, the Chicken Inn then reverted back to their first half approach, keeping position and constructing from the back. Suddenly their game appeared to regain the life it had in the first half. Believe it, it took Chicken Inn almost a quarter of an hour of the second half to come up with anything close to a goal scoring opportunity, and that a free kick crashed against the wall by Tarumga. Bosso then responded by bringing on Ralph Matema in place of Casimiro Chizakwa. No sooner was Matema on the pitch than he saw his point blank shot blocked again by the outstanding Zendera. Chicken Inn then introduced Michel Katsoero in place of Kenan Komo. Shortly after, former Chicken Inn defender Felix Chindugwe almost presented Moses Ndemera with an easy chance after the Highlanders captain failed to be decisive in the box. Ariel Sibanda saved Bosso the blushes with his save. 16 minutes shy of full-time, Highlanders finally got their reward when a patient build-up culminated in Tendai Ngulube enjoying acres of space to unleash a grounder controlled on the turn and buried with a rising shot by Bruce Kangwa. Finally, Zendera had been beaten by, of all people, Bruce Kangwa's weaker right foot. 2 minutes after the goal, Nox Mtizwa set Bruce Kangwa on the loose at their left wing, but over-elaboration by the latter cost Bosso what appeared a promising opportunity. How Chicken Inn reliable forward Michel Katsoero failed to regain his side's lead on the 83rd minute remains a mystery after he found himself with a great chance to strike home only to shoot way over the bar. Shortly after, traffic was back at the Chicken Inn goal, but Raman Kutsanzira directed his shot off target. With Bosso back on the driving seat, another patient move pierced the Gamecocks apart in midfield, eventually releasing Bruce Kangwa wide on the left to send an inch-perfect cross met with a diving header by Gabriel Nyoni that failed to sneak home via the far post. With full time looming, Obadiah Tarumbwa blew away a golden chance to finish off his former club after latching onto a Katswairo setup only to side foot his touch above the target. 1-1 at full time, then, and straight after the final whistle, the two teams went to penalties. Highlanders head coach Errol Akpey, on his side, spent for the first time on a competitive match, emphasized the power and pace on the ball to his players, and the instruction appears to have yielded fruitful results. Chickenin were first to take the penalties with Guide Goddard, who saw his shot saved by Ariel Sibanda before Bruce Kangwa put Poso ahead with his rising kick. It was 1-0 at penalties. Michel Katswairo was lucky to see his penalty bobble home after a deflection by Ariel Sibanda, but Noxon Tizwa shot Poso back in front at 2-1 with his strike. Brian Juru then made it 2-0 with his rising shot, but Poso retained their one-goal advantage off Raman Kutsanzira's kick that Zendera mainly attempted to stop. It was 3-2 in Poso's favour, with both sides having taken three kicks. Substitute Fizwel Madazi then saw his kicker punched away by Ariel Sibanda, and all Poso needed at that stage was to bury their fourth kick and win the match with one more round of kicks to go. That responsibility was left for veteran Eric Mzingwa to execute, and he did not disappoint, sending Zendera the wrong way to spark wild scenes of Highlander celebrations both on and off the pitch. It was a perfect starter for Poso's expatriate coach Errol Akpey, and such was the joy amongst the Highlander supporters that you never know whether it was still the victory over Chicken Inn or perhaps they had moved a gear up to celebrate their 90th birthday. Either way, both are worth the proper fanfare.